Hi guys, welcome back to Selenium Automation Design from scratch and the practical hands-on. So in the previous set of videos, we have seen some basic introduction to Maven and all the theoretical concepts related to Maven has been covered, and also a high level overview of this particular picture pictorial representation which was represented over here has been discussed, and also we have given some insights to the basic terminologies that are available with Maven, and all the concepts which are linked to Maven has been covered. And also we have discussed about the form.xml file, and also finally we have come up with the clarification reference links which are discussed in the previous set of videos. So those are the set of links that are available with the Maven homepage, and if you have any clarifications about working with Maven, they are real and very much useful links. So today, let's get into our framework design and how we are going to relate this Maven build tool in our framework. And how practically we are going to use this Maven in our framework design. So let's get into our framework design from scratch. So let's see. So for designing a framework, as we already discussed, Maven is really useful in building up the framework structure. So the project structure can be built up using the artifacts available as a part of Maven. So there are many artifacts available for Maven, which the artifacts are the real templates that are available for use with a particular kind of project. Say a web application, a particular artifact is available for a simple project, a particular artifact is available. So let's see what is the artifact that will be used in here. So we are going to basically go with a simple artifact. So how to create a Maven project? So by navigating to File, New, and click on Others, there you can see if the Maven plugin has been integrated with Eclipse. You will be able to see Maven over here. Click on that, it will expand, and then click on Maven project. Click Next. So you can see over here in the new Maven project creation phase, there is a checkbox which reads create a simple project. So this artifact is used to create a simple Maven project. So we'll be discussing, let's see, if we don't want to go with a simple Maven project, where are the other archetypes available? So don't check the checkbox and click on Next. These are the available list of artifacts that are available with Maven. So by default, the Kickstart artifact is selected. So we will work with only Kickstart artifacts. It's really useful for our framework design, and other kind of artifacts are not used by us. It depends upon our kind of project structure. If we wanted to go based on the project structure, we are going to go with other artifacts. So for our working, our framework design, simple artifact or the Kickstart artifact is enough. So click back and click on check the box, create a sample project, simple project, Kickstart artifact, and then yes, we wanted to go with the default workspace location and click Next. Now, as a part of the earlier discussions, we have discussed what is group ID, what is artifact ID, and the packaging, etc. All these things have been covered. So let's have a quick recap. Artifact ID is the final artifact that we are going to get out of this project. So by that name, we'll get the output, final result. So we are saying that packaging, we wanted to get this final project as a jar file. So what happens is, like, once the project has been built and it was successfully compiled and converted into binary files, those binary files will be shipped in the form of compressed in the form of jar file, and the name that will be given for this particular output result, the jar file, will be the artifact followed by the version name. So what is group ID useful for? As we have already discussed in the previous sessions, group ID is a reverse domain name. The name convention used is a reverse domain name, and it is used for identifying which organization is having this project, or the main project structure followed by it's like a main project structure. Like assume like if you are having different modules within a project, so the main project structure, project name will be the group ID, and the submodules will be the artifact ID. Example, Apache is having so many projects under it as modules, or some project, different projects under it. So assume Maven is one of the projects under it. So org.apache will be the group ID, and Maven will be the artifact ID. So artifact ID is used for uniquely representing the project under a group, under a group of projects. So let's give a name for group ID. Or we can just go with a reverse domain name, or if you are going and building up this automation framework for a particular client, we can give the group ID as a client name, and then artifact ID will be your project name. So Selenium framework, and the version, and then you want it to output in the form of a jar file, and then click finish. So based on the Kickstart artifact project type template, Maven had created the project structure for us. So let's see, as I told, the project structure, the project name will be the artifact ID, that is the Selenium framework. And then you can see the project structure is as follows. There is the folder structure or directory for source files, that is the development files can be placed over SRC main Java. And then resources related to the development can be placed under here, and resources related to, sorry, the source files related to the testing team or the unit test can be placed over here, and then the resources related to testing, unit testing or the functional testing or integration testing can be placed under test resources. So basically, since we are concentrating only on testing part, we are going to utilize SRC test Java and SRC test resources. We are not going to utilize SRC main Java and SRC main resources. So how this will be utilized in a big organization, any organization? So basically developers will write the code, and that code will be placed under SRC main Java, and the resources related to, what are the resources? Resources are like the jar files or the dependencies that will be placed under the SRC main resources, or any configuration files or any XML files, the configuration files, test data, etc. will be placed under the resources. And the unit tests, which the developers or the testers will be writing, they will be placed under SRC test Java, source test Java, and also the functional test what we are going to cover up using Selenium or any framework, any API, that will be placed under SRC test Java. And the resources related to those things will be placed under SRC test resource, source test resources. So here we can place the test data set, any configuration files, property files over here. And then what is the JRE library that we are going to utilize? So if you wanted to change the Java library, execution library, we can change it by clicking it, right click, properties, change the execution environment. So I'm changing it to Java SE 1.8. Click apply and close. So now our execution environment is Java 1.8. So this is the place where all the compiled files related to SRC main, developers related to bin files will be placed over here, and testers related compiled files will be placed under the test. And target is output directory where our artifact will be created, that is the jar file will be created, and it will be placed and all the reports will be placed over this target, and all the site related information will be placed under the target folder. So this is basically the output directory. Source is an output directory for binary files. Target is the output directory for the reports and all those things. And these are the directories for the resources and class files related to development and class files related to the source files related to testing. And finally, the form.xml file, which is created over here. So by now getting over here, you can see, as I told, the group ID, the client name we have defined, and the artifact ID, the ID which is uniquely defined the project, artifact ID and the version. So this is how the form.xml file is. And now, how to add the dependency, how to add the description. So basically before that, let's see what are all the tags that are available in the form.xml file. So with the newer versions of Eclipse, as you have seen the auto suggest with the Eclipse series of videos, the same way auto suggest was available in the newer version of Eclipse. So you can see if you give tag open, you can see all the list of tags that are available as a part of Eclipse. Sorry, form.xml file. So if you place over here, you can see that. When we place the cursor over here, you can see the description of it. So what it reads is the artifact ID is the identifier for this artifact that is unique within the group given by the group ID. An artifact ID, artifact is something that is either product, either produced or used with project. Examples of the artifacts produced by Maven for a project include jars, source, binary distributions, and vars. And next, let's see the next tag. So we can see all the tags that are available. If you want here to see the description or basic idea of the particular tag that is available, you can set up the particular tag and press control space so that you can see. So you can see when you click on this particular tag, you can see the information related to that particular tag name. Contributors who are developing or contributing to this project, and dependencies, as we already told, these are the dependencies that are supporting our project, basically without which we will not be able to work with. So these are things that our project is dependent upon, like example, our source files related to, our files related to, the APIs related to the Selenium or TestNG, all these things are the dependencies. Description. This is a brief idea of what our project is, a detailed description of the project. Developers, self-explanatory, distribution management, group ID. So you are seeing that group ID is a universal, unique identifier for the project. It's normal to use a fully qualified package name to distinguish it from other projects with a similar name. As I already told, org.apache.maven. And then, inception year, issue management, licenses, mailing list, model version, modules, name, organization, packaging, plugin repositories, and then prerequisites, profiles, properties, reporting, reports, repositories, SCM, URL versions. So basically, we'll be looking at some of this as a part of the form.xml configuration. So first let's look into building the form.xml file with the dependencies. So as we are seeing, the various components that were required as a part of the framework design for the Selenium, TestNG, XMPPoS API, and Apache POI API. These are the basic things which were required at the first hand. So let's configure these dependencies. So how to get these dependencies? So we can directly place over here in the form.xml file, configure those things over here, or else we can add it in the dependencies tag, and that will add up to the form.xml file. So here also you can see project, organization, SCM, source control management, issue management. Parent form, if there is any, and properties, if you want to create the properties. So we'll be looking at all the things one after the other. So as a first part, as a starter, let's add the dependencies that are required for this particular framework design. So how to get these dependencies? Just type in Google search. Type in Google it. Maven Selenium Java dependency. So click on the first link, it's available. Oh, 1 minute. So you can see, as we have already discussed, this is a central repository where all the dependencies are available. So click on that. So you can see what we require by the Selenium Java jar files to be introduced into our project. So click on that. And see, the latest version that is available is 3.141.59. The repository is the central. So central Maven repository. So you click on this link. So you can see the dependency is defined like this: dependency, group ID, artifact ID, version. So based on this, if you are configuring this thing, as we already told, group ID is uniquely used to identify it among the various things available on the web. This project is uniquely identified on this particular central repository using this name, and post that under that it will search for this particular project using the artifact ID selenium-java, and that particular jar file or the output that was configured, the packaging that was configured, will be produced into our local repository, local Maven repository. So it will basically, for this we need to have an internet connection at an initial phase, because our Maven is going to download these configured dependencies from the central repository to the local repository. So in order to configure this, we can do it in two ways. We can just copy the group ID and the artifact ID and the version, and we can place it over here. Click on add and then place the group ID and copy the artifact ID. And then the version. Okay. And click on OK. So now this is added into our form.xml file. So we have configured Selenium Java. So let's see. So you can see over here, it was clearly configured in our project. So now, if you wanted this thing to be downloaded, the Selenium jar file needed to be downloaded into our local repository. So further, click on save. So it is building the workspace, that implies it was downloading. See, it was downloading source and Java docs related to Selenium Java jar file which you have configured. So you can see over here Maven dependencies folder have been created, and under the directory Selenium related jar files have been downloaded. So now it has been downloaded to our local repository. So where's our local repository? Let's see where is our local repository. So it was available over here. Click on preferences, Maven, and then under user settings. Yeah, it was available under user settings. So you can see over here, see users m2.m2 repository. This is the place where this will be downloaded from. So this is the place where it will be downloaded. All the jar files will be downloaded into this particular place. So let's get back. Org.selenium. So org, the org it will be downloaded. Org.apache. Org.seleniumhq. So it is with this particular folder structure, it will get created. Seleniumhq. Under this Selenium, so you can see this is a jar file that is downloaded in the Selenium Java. This was downloaded. Plus everything over here. So Selenium, we have configured the Selenium dependency. Now let's see the other dependencies that needs to be configured. So let's see how to do it directly as a part of the form.xml file configuration instead of putting it in over here. Now let's see how to configure testng. Testng Maven testng dependency. So this is the central repository as we already discussed, and click on the first thing that is available. So these are the beta versions, so might not be stable. So we need to go for the stable version, 6.14.2. So copy the dependency tag to dependency tag. Create. And then go to form.xml file. Inside dependencies, we will have multiple dependency tags. So now save it. So testng.xml. You can see testng.xml needs to be downloaded. So let's see where the testng.xml is there. So yeah, you can see over here the jar file has been downloaded with the source files and the binaries. Now let's configure Apache Point, Maven dependency, and then the extent reports. Maven Apache Point dependency. Click on that and click on the link that is available. And then click on this particular link version. Copy the dependency tag, and then place it over here. So this is a comment in XML file. So now let's see, this dependency is being downloaded. You can see building workspace. So it is building the workspace. Yeah, this completed. And now we can see the Apache Point somewhere in there. Yeah, Point files. So what actually, what's the use of this configuration? Why are you configuring the dependency like this? So a dependency can have multiple dependencies within it. So Apache Point is dependent upon some other dependencies, some other tags, some other dependencies, some other projects it depends upon. So when you configure Apache Point, it will be looking out for all the dependents, all its dependents, sub-dependents. Like, you can think like Apache Point is a parent and it depends upon some other child projects. those all side projects are necessary for utilizing Apache Phone. So what happens when you configure in Maven? It will locate all the related dependencies for Apache Phone, and it will download not only Apache Phone but also its related dependencies so that we can work with Apache Phone at ease. So this is the basic idea of dependency concept. All the transient dependencies, they say, they call it as a transient dependencies. One thing depends upon multiple other modules. So these all transient modules will also be downloaded along with the main thing which we configure. So that's one of the major use of Maven dependencies. If we download the dependencies in general and plug in those dependencies manually, what happens is, like, we don't know which Apache Phone is dependent upon some other things. So at that point of time, we'll only configure the jar file into our libraries, into the class path, but we'll not be configuring the other things which are dependent, Apache Phone is dependent on. So at that point of time, we will not be able to work properly with Apache Phone, and we will not be able to understand what's the reason for this. So Maven takes care of all these things. That is one of the basic uses of Maven. So let's see what's the dependencies which we have. Next, let's configure extent reports. Maven extent reports dependency. Click on it. Click on the latest version. The latest version available, as we have seen, 2.4.1.2. Let's configure that. So let's remove the comment and click on save. So it is building up our project. It's building the workspace with extent reports jar file or API. Now all our dependencies have been downloaded. So what are all the dependencies that we downloaded? Let's see, what are the things we configured? Selenium, TestNG, and Apache 4 and relevant codes. Let's once again configure the Selenium dependency. Maven Selenium Java dependency. And then over here. And copy this and place it over here. So here one basic question comes up. So how do Maven know that where to download this particular project from? I mean, what is the repository it needs to identify this project from? We are saying that group ID is unique ID for identifying among the group of projects that are available over somewhere. What is that somewhere? Where it was? So how do Maven identify this? So as we already discussed in the previous two videos, the effective form, which is the parent form of Maven, that is a main resource for Maven to identify the resources from. All the configurations and all the things have been done by default in the parent form. And what we are doing is, like, we are overriding on top of those things whatever dependencies we want. It is like the parent form is like the main one. That is the parent child relationship in the inheritance criteria, in the inheritance concept in Java, the OOPS concept. The same thing is followed over here. Like, the parent form is a parent, and this whatever we are configuring as a part of our project is a child. So all the things have been configured in the parent form.xml file, and in child, that is whatever the form.xml file configuration file that is available as a part of project, we are configuring whatever dependencies that will be that were required and what all changes that were required as a part of this particular project. So let's see where that is available, where the parent form is available. PORM. So here click on effective form, you can see entire structure with all the predefined setup has been configured in the effective form, that is the parent form for the project. So you can see everything is defined based on this. A project structure is created, and based on this thing, all the dependencies will be downloaded. So our basic question, how is Maven identifying the central repository from where it need to pick up this particular dependency that we are configuring? So you can see over here, come down, here, central ID, URL is the particular place from where the Maven is identifying all this project uniquely from. So just copy it. And then let's navigate over the web with this particular URL. So you can see all the projects that are available on the central repository here. You can see all the projects that are available in the central repository of Maven. So whatever we configure, it will be checking over here in this particular thing, and then it will be downloading from. So let's see what are the next things that are available. Plugin configurations and the build configurations. As we already discussed, the source directory configuration. This is the source directory for the developers. And the script source directory. This is the test source directory for us. Output directory. Framework target under target under classes folder, the binary files will be the Java files will be executed, so we compile, and then it will be the binary files, so the compiled class files will be placed over here, the executable files will be picked up from this place while we are running on this particular binary files. So during the compilation phase, it picks up the source files from here and here, and then it will convert into binary files, and then it will place under the target classes folder. This is for source and this is for the test classes. And then this is the resource directory, as we already seen. So these are all the configurations. Based on this configuration, a project has been created. This is where the archetype has been developed. The archetype defined is a simple kickstart archetype in which the project structure has been defined over here in this particular fashion, and based on this, the folder structure has been created by this. And then we can see what are the default plugins that are available that have been already configured. Assembly plugin, dependency plugin, release plugin, clean, and Maven resources. Char plugin, compiler plugin, and Maven Shofar plugin. So everything has been defined. All the plugins have been defined as a default. So if you want to modify these configurations, then those things will be configured in the pom.xml file over here. So it is like concept of overriding. So whatever it was there here, we're just overriding and putting. To override that, we need to put over here. We need to configure those things in the pom.xml file in our project. Next, let's see what is the scope of these dependencies. So assume, and we have seen already the different scopes that are available as a part of Maven lifecycle, whether it is a compilation phase, compilation scope, or it is a test phase, etc. So let's see. What is the scope of Selenium? So if we go into effective form, you can see the scope of Selenium is compile. And what is the scope of test ng? It is for test. So all the tests which you are writing utilizing the Selenium API will be compiled and it will be placed into the predefined project structure, the project structure which is predefined. That is, under the target folder, all the files will be placed, the compiled files, that is the binary files. The dot class files will be placed in the target folder. So what is the phase or the scope of TestNG? TestNG is used for picking up the compiled files, that is the binary files, dot class files, and then running using those things. So TestNG is used for running the unit tests. That is the executed file, the compiled phase, compiled files, it will pick up, and based on that, whatever the executions that were done as a part of the compiled, binary files, using those execution steps which were defined, it will pick up step by step and it will start compilation. So it will start working on the browser, on the application. So Apache Poi is similar to Selenium. So we are using Apache Poi API and we are writing some code, some libraries, test methods, or some, we can say, that is our libraries for data-driven framework, which is utilized for the data-driven framework. So those things will be converted into the binaries. So even similarly, the Extent API, Extent Reports API, is used for compilation phase only. So the scope of these things, these dependencies, are compilation. And the scope of TestNG is for testing purpose, testing phase. Now let's navigate back and let's see how to configure the plugins. So what are the plugins that are really useful for us? So the basic plugin, or the compiler plugin, used for compiling the project, all the source files in our project, and then placing it into the defined class file, class folder structure, where we need all the test classes or the source classes should be placed, compiled and placed into. So it will be taken care by the compiler plugin. Compiler plugin compiles all the source files and place it in the appropriate path, the compiling it into binary files. And then next important plugin is the Surefire plugin. Maven Surefire plugin is used for executing the unit tests. So it is useful for testing purpose, I mean executing the test, running on the test environment, GRE. So let's see how to configure the plugins. You configure the dependencies. So if you wanted to see the dependency hierarchy, you can click on this and you can see all the dependencies: Selenium, Poi, Extent Reports, etc. Everything was clean. Then let's get back. If you wanted to see the outline of the configurations, what we have done in this XML file, you can just navigate over here and there we'll be having an outline. So if you wanted to see the outline of this configuration file, you can just click Alt Shift W shortcut, and then you can see what are all the things available, all the views. So we wanted to see the outline, so click on outline, select the outline, and here over here you can see, expanding it, the outline of the configuration file. So under dependencies, we have configured all the things. So this is our project which we have defined, the group ID and the version, and these are the dependencies that we have configured till now. And now let's see how to configure the plugins. As we already discussed, the basic plugins that we need to configure for compilation phase and for the test phase. For compilation phase, we need we require the compiler plugin, and for execution phase, we require the Surefire plugin for test execution, for calling the test ng. So let's see how to define that. So that needs to be defined under the build tag. So if you get any doubt on how to configure, so we can just directly navigate to parent POM, and then you can see what is the hierarchy that was configured. So it was configured under the build. You can see. Plugins. So as you have seen here, the dependencies repository is this one, and the plugins repository is this one. The same repository is holding both the plugins and the dependencies. And now let's see how it was configured. The plugins were configured. So dependencies are configured directly under the main project tag, but plugins are defined under the build tag. So you can see under the build project build tag, the dependency, sorry, the plugins are managed. So this, we need to follow the same thing. So the shortcut used for formatting, as you have seen in the Eclipse, select all, Control A, and then Control Shift F used for formatting. Now we configure the dependencies. Now we are going to configure the plugins. So as you have seen, under the build tag, we need to configure. So what the build tag is. So we can see what it was, the basic description of what it was going. It is information required to build the project. So in this, what are all things will be configured? Like all the parts related to, all the configuration parts related to source directory, script source directory, and the test directory, where the binaries should be placed, and all those things, the target directory, and the final name of the project, and everything was defined over here, and also the plugins were configured over here, which are used for building the project, and also which are used for executing the project execution. So we need to define it under the build tag, control space, auto stress. This is the auto stress. So now you can see under the outline, build tag has come. Now we need to define the plugins. So we are defining two plugins. So we need to write. So you can see once you have configured the build tag, under build tag, what are all the tags that are available are clearly defined over here. Filters, final name, output directory, plugins, plugin management, resources, all the things were configured under the build tag. So it's very really useful. This kind of configuration, this kind of auto service was not available in the previous versions, earlier versions of Eclipse. So it was really easy now for configuring. Build. And now we are configuring plugins, so we need to plugins, and under that we are configuring plugin. So what plugin we wanted? Compiler plugin. So similarly, how we search for dependency? The same way we need to go and search the dependencies. If you write the man, if you search with Maven plugins, then you will get a first link, and in the first link, as you have seen, the central repository of Maven. In that, you can see this is the home directory of Maven, and in this, all the plugins are defined. So we have seen in the parent form, clean, compiler, deploy, and some of these are defined already as a default. You can see over here, wanted to get the outline of this. Alt+W and outline. It defines, okay. It is used for defining only that particular thing. Okay, this is used to outline only our current project form.xml file. So let's navigate down. Okay. Let's navigate to the plugins. So what are the basic plugins that are available? Maven and run plugin, assembly plugin, dependency plugin, and release plugin, clean plugin, deploy plugin, Maven resources plugin, jar plugin, compiler plugin, shortcut plugin, install plugin, deploy plugin, swipe plugin. So you might get it out. Shortcut plugin is there, compiler plugin is already there. Why we need to configure it again? Yeah, why we need to configure? So basically we are overwriting these configurations. You can see in the effective form, it was not defined